We are discussing the letter C, the chapter 1 which is getting started. Integer and float conversions. Whenever we are dealing with program, there are certain conversions. One is called implicit, one will see as explicit. So how this conversion take place? An arithmetic operation between an integer and integer. So if both are integers, they will give the result as integer. When we have both as real, that is the floating point values, they will give you result as floating point. But when we are dealing with an integer and real, what it will give? It will give you real. Why? Because the integer is having the lower memory requirement than the real. So the lower requirement memory of this integer will be first changed into real. That is, if you are adding 2 with 3.0 or 3.26, this 2 will be converted to 2.0, because in memory you want, say, if this is say 4 byte. So if this is 4 byte and this is 2 byte, how can you add a 2 byte with a 4 byte? This has to be converted into 4 byte, means the values has to be kept in 4 byte, then 4 byte and 4 byte can be added. So this is how it is converted. 2.0 will be first converted, 2 will be converted to 2.0, then it will be added with 3.2. So what you are going to get, these are the practical example. 5 by 2 is what? It gives you 2.5. Since both are integers, you will get only 2, because this will be truncated, you will get 2. But since 5.0 and 2, as I said, just this will become 2.0, this will become 5.0, this will become, these are already 5.0, 2.0, then you will get 2.5. What about this case? 2 by 5 is what? 5, if you divide 2, 5 is simply 5.0542, 0.4. So you get 0.4. But what happens here? Because both are integer, this only 0 will be taken, 0.4 will be truncated. So you get 0. What about this one? 2.0 by 5. Because 5 will be converted to 5.0, 2 will be converted to 2.0. These are already 2.0, 5.0. You will get 0.4. Type conversions in assignment. When you are dealing with an assignment, then how the type will convert? See, first of all, the left hand side and right hand side, they may be of different data type. So the value of expression is promoted or demoted, which it totally depends on what is on the left hand side. If this is an integer and you have say 2.3, this 0.3 will be truncated because this is an integer, say x is an integer. But if x is equal to 2 and this is a float, x is a float, so 2 will be promoted to 2.0. Okay. See, integer I and b, we have I as 3.5, b as 30. This is an integer, this will only get 3. 0.5 will be truncated. How about b? B is 30, but this is float. So 30, this will be 30.00 and 0 something, right? So these are the values. You get 3.5, this will be truncated, you get only 3. For 30, you will get 30.000, because it has been assigned on the left hand side to the float value or float variable. And this rule applies to any expression also. See, this is an expression. Now here what happens, this ABC, all these ABC, these are what? These are simply integers. But whatever result will come, this result, say it is an integer. I don't know what it will come, but if it is an integer, the value which it, or say if it is an integer, it is well and good, because S is our integer. These are all float here. But if these values are giving you some integer value, it is okay. But if there are giving some float value, say 8.36, only it will be taken by S, 3.36 will be truncated. Let us take formal example. See, 2 by 9. 2 by 9 will give what? Because K is integer here and A is a very real number. So 2 by 9, as I just said, because 2 by 9 will give 0 point if you divide it. But we are not interested in finding that value, because we know that when you have 0 point something, and if it is an integer, only 0 will be taken. A decimal, any value after decimal will be truncated. But here 2.0 by 9.0 you will get, but whatever is computed, say 0 point something, it will be computed. 0.222 will be the value actually. 0.222. But because it is an integer, it will truncate all these decimal values. This is same with these two. 9 by 2 will be 4.5, because this is integer, 0.5 will be truncated, only 4 will come. Similar is the case with these all, because they will all give you this, they all will give you 4.5. But this is an integer. Integer will take only the integral value, decimal point, and after that will be truncated. Similar is case with this 2 by 9, because this is actually a real number. But 2 by 9 will actually give you the, because both are integers, it will give you 0.222, but these are integers, it will give you only 0. So 0.0 will be assigned. 2.0 by 9.0, it will give you proper values, because all this will be changed to 2.0, this will be 2.0 and 9.0 already. Here what will happen? This will be 4.5. But since this is 4.5 and these two are integer, this will, 9 by 2 will give you only 4. And this 4, when it is assigned to A, that real number, then it will become 4.0. But here the case is different. 9.0 and 2.0 will give you 4.5. 4.5 can be assigned to A. Similarly, 9.0, 2.0 can be assigned to A. And this 4.5 can be assigned to A. And you just have to see what I have explained you, that what on the left hand side you have. Depending upon that, the promotion and demotion will take place. Hierarchy of operation. Hierarchy of operation means, if you have say 2 into x minus 3y, how it will be computed? Either this way or this way. Either this way or that way. We don't know. A divided by B star C, or A by B first, this will be computed in star C. So we ought to have some hierarchy. We need to know which will be done first, which will be done later. So we have a proper hierarchy. Hierarchy is that this star and this modulo and division, these all have highest level precedence. Before that we have this also, round bracket actually. But because we are talking about the operators, these three first, then plus minus, then assignment. And there are certain things you must know. First of all, as I just said, whatever you keep inside the round brackets, that will be done first, and then the others will be done. We will explain it with an example. You have to determine the hierarchy of operations first of all, and evaluate the following expression. See, first you have to do 2 into 3, star is the first, it will be 6. Then 6 by 4, it will be 1. Then next one is 4 by 4, it will give you 1. Then we have 5 by 8, it will give you 0. Then after this, you can just add these two. Add this 2 with 8, subtract this with 2, and then this 8 can be added with 0, so you get 8. You have to find the hierarchy and find out the solution. So first of all, 3 by 2. First, this will be done. This will be 1.5. So you will get only integral value. So 1 will be the result. Then 1 into 4 is 4. Then 3 by 8. 3 by 8 will give you some 0.00 point, some value 3, 4, something values. You know, I am not interested in this, because I am able to see that only these dot, and after that will be value will be truncated. So I am only interested in the 0 value. Only 0 will come. Then we have 4 plus 0. 0, that is 4, and then 4 plus 3 is 7. So we don't have any Bodmer's rule type, you know, here. We just have to see what kind of, I'll tell you how exactly it is done, because we have some associativity rule. But right now we don't have any Bodmer's rule, but we have various operators, and these operators are realized by the precedence. But first of all, if any algebraic expression is there, you can't just write it like this as you do it in copy pen, or you have seen in on the book. No, not like that. This star, this into or x has to be converted into star. This you have to put a divide or slash here. This has to be changed into star. This ABC has to be kept into the bracket, these two bracket, and you have to use for this a division sign, or you can say a slash. Here also 2 star B star, and then keep it in the bracket so that you know you understand well. This again you have to use a star. So these all you know you have to understand, because this is not just writing things in your copy pen. This is actually writing in the program. So when you are writing a C program or any programming language, you have to use operator everywhere. Associativity of operators. So when an expression contains two operations, they have equal priority. Say into and star, or into and division. Then what to do? Because they have equal priority, there is a tie. So this tie, how to resolve it? We'll use the associativity. So it can be from left to right, it can be from right to left, right to left. So left to right associativity means the left operand must be unambiguous. Unambiguous means the value, it should not be in any sub expression, means it should be a single value. It will be single, it has to be single value, no expression. In the case of right to left, similarly right to left, we apply right to left when the right operand is unambiguous. That is the number which comes, or the expression, or the value which comes, not expression, value which comes is not involved in any expression. I'll show you an example. 3 × 3/2 * 5. Take this 3/2 * 5. See, if we take the division, this division, in this division, the left is 3, it is unambiguous, it is a proper number. But here we don't know whether it is 2 or whether it is 2 * 5. So the left is actually unambiguous, it is clean, right is not. And if we take a star, see the left hand side, if the left hand side is unambiguous, is ambiguous actually, it's because the star, the right operand is okay, 5, it is clean, but this we don't know, it is 3/2 or it is 2, which we have to take, we don't know. So since this division and star, they have left to right associativity, and only this has unambiguous left operand. See, division and star has left to right associativity, and this has, as we just saw, this division has left as unambiguous and it is left to right. So the operation will be left to right with division. We'll consider one more expression. See, a equal to b equal to 3. Here both the assignment operator have the same priority, this one also, this one also. So we'll see the first of all the both the operators. See this one. For this, the left is unambiguous, it is clean, but right we don't know whether it is b or it is b equal to 3, we don't know. For this one, we have right as clean, but left as, it can be b, it can be a equal to b, right? We don't know. So both these have right to left associativity. Please understand, this assignment operator has right to left, right to means left associativity, this thing. And only the second one, this one, has the right operator, value as unambiguous. So we'll take this first, we'll take the second first, this will be applied first. Let us take one more expression. Here into and star enjoy the same priority, they have the same priority. But if you take star, left and right both are clean, no problem. If you take division, C and D, left hand side, right hand side, no problem. Anything can be taken. So both operands are ambiguous. So it depends on the compiler whether it wants to do it first or this to first. So it totally depends on the compiler what to be done first. Control instruction in C. So we have various control instruction. We'll be discussing them in detail. This actually decides the flow of control, which has to be done, which has to be done when, or whether this expression has to be done again and again. We'll be dealing with them, you know, in quite a detail. So they are sequence control instruction, selection decision control instruction, repetition or loop control instruction, case control instructions. We have many. So these, I'm just going to skip this right now, because you know, looping, decision control, and then if, loop, while, else, all will come. That will be, we will be taking a lot of examples and explaining it. So let us summarize what we have seen. There are three primary constants and variable types in C, which are basically integer, float and character. The variable name can be maximum of this. I don't say this to be maximum. You can take any length. There is no restriction at all. But what I am trying to say here is the best is to keep it to 31 characters. Do not use keyword as a variable name, because these are keywords. They are reserved words. An expression may contain any sequence of constant, variable and operators. There is no boundation. And operators, they have, if they have equal precedence, they are evaluated using left to right or right to left associativity. The left to right associativity means left operand must be unambiguous, it should be clean, it should not be in some sub expression, and right to left associativity means the right operand of a operator must be unambiguous. The input output in C is done by scanf and printf. So this is all about this first chapter we are taking. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.